So hello, today I'm going to talk about how to import 3D MCAD data into PCB template and how you can place the 3D shape data in PCB template. So this is my PCB template. Let me switch to the 3D mode. Just press 3 on your keyboard and it will go from 2D to 3D mode. Okay, let me show you from where I'm getting the 3D data. So this is the website, which is called GrabCAD. From here, I already downloaded the 3D strip file for this PCB. So let me import that file. So you can, for that, you can go to the place and then choose 3D body. And here, this is the file. So here you can see that. You have to just click on the PCB with the left mouse click one time, and to come out of this mode, you press escape. Okay, then next thing is that we have to bring in the same coordinate axis like the template PCB. So for that, what you have to do, you have to just click here. You have to go to the properties. This properties is available under this panels. We have to rotate this. Let's say 90 degree. That's how it looks like. There are many ways to place this 3D. Let me zoom here because I'm going to select this point. So once you will choose these options, tools, 3D body placement, and add a snap point from vertices. So here you can see that at the bottom, pick the step model to add snap points. So you have to click here on this step model, and then it's asking pick vertex where the snap point will be added. So I'm going to add it here. You can add more snap points, but one is enough for me. And to come out of this snap point mode, you have to press on the escape. And to see this snap point, what you can do, you can go to the view configuration. So this view configuration is available under this panels. You have to just click here. If it's look like this, then you have to click here system colors, and under the system colors, you have to enable this custom snap points. You enable this, then you can see here the snap point. I will go to 3D mode, and then I will just grab this snap point and place it here. It's easy in the 2D mode. So here you can see that it's exactly placed at the center of the this Fujitsu marker. So let me go to the 3D mode. So here you can see that. This 3D step data is perfectly placed on my PCB, but on the back side you can see, let me rotate this. You can rotate by pressing the shift, and then you have to hold the right side of the mouse, and then you have to just drag it. Okay, so here you can see that it's not placed properly. There is some gap between them. So let me bring it to the original position. And then what you can do, let me check my stack from the PCB. So design, you can go and then layer stack manager. And it should be 1.5. So here you can see this is the core, and it's a two-layer PCB, and this is the core, which is very thin, 0.32, and this the thickness of the total board. Here you can see that under the board information, it's 0.411. So let me change this. So you have to just select this, and from here you can choose the material for dielectric core, and this one I will take core 043. So it's 1.49, and the rest copper layer, shoulder, top shoulder, and top overlay, and as well as the bottom layer, and then bottom shoulder and bottom overlay. So it will be including all those things, it will be around 1.5. So we will check one more time the board information. So it's 1.59, which is the standard. So save this. Yes, save. And when I look here again, then it looks to me there is some offset. So let me adjust the offset. So I will send this board to minus 1.59. So now you can see that this board is perfectly placed on my PCB. And yeah, that's how you can place this. And so to take the board contour of this this step file, what you can do first, you have to go to the, just for the information I'm showing you, what exactly in this 3D MCAD data, whether all this component and the PCB is the same file or they are different. That you can check here under panel, and then you can go to the PCB. So in this PCB window, you should choose always 3D models. If you choose something else, then it will not come. I mean, you cannot see the these files, and then you have to choose this free models. Once you choose these free models, then here in the model, it will show you all the models which are available. So it has a two parts. The one is the 40 pin header. I think this is that part, and that you can go here and then you can hide that. Yeah, so that's the part, and I think this is the PCB. Yeah, so let me hide this also. Yeah, okay, so again I will turn it on, and here again you can see that you can change the opacity of the PCB. To import the board contour of this PCB, what we have to do, go to the design, board shape, and then define board shape from 3D body. And then here you can see that it's asking you pick a 3D body. So you have to just click on the 3D body and then choose the face. So again, one more time, you have to click there. So it has chosen this face. Okay, this face will be aligned with the face of our PCB. And then after that, you have to select this. In our case, everything is matching, so we don't need to choose any of them. But here, do not modify the model position. Then close. And let me go to the 2D mode by pressing 2. And once you are in a 2D mode, then what you have to do, you have to go here and board shape, and then create primitive from the board shape that you have to select. And instead of top layer, I will go for the keep out layer, and I'm choosing this include cutouts and delete the existing non-net line zircon layer. So at the moment, I don't have any other keep outs, so that's why, in case if something is there apart from this board contour of the PCB, then it's automatically delete those. For example, if I'm having somewhere here the keep outs, in that case, so I'm normally placing this in the keep out. That is useful for the to write the design rules. So let me shift this my text from here outside from the body of the PCB. And yeah, that's how it looks like. And then again, you can go to the design board shape and then create board shape. And then there is no board shape. So what I will do, I will add here one mechanical layer. And let's call this board contour, this layer. So you can see that this layer is available here, which is called board contour. Then now I will again go to the design, board shape, and then create primitives from board shape. And then I will choose that board contour. So, okay. And let me go to the single mode and check whether it has taken those board contour and keep out or not. So by pressing Shift S, you can go to the single mode. I save the PCB, and then here you can find at the bottom those layers, board contour. So here you can see that it has taken the shape, and then keep out. So keep out is this one. So you can see that it has taken the board contour of the PCB. So let me go to the 3D mode again. And then here, what you have to do, if you don't see anything on your PCB, then as I said, you have to go to the PCB window, select here 3D models, and here you have to enable your PCB. That's why you cannot see. So just click on that and you can see the PCB. So that is one of the way. Then let me show you the another way. Let me shift this and go to the 2D mode, and I will also shift this to the corner. And here I'm having one more Fujitsu marker. So now it looks better. So let me show you how you can use the second option. For example, now we have one version of this PCB, and you got, let's say you have a prototype A, and you got the new step file from your mechanical design department, and you have to place this PCB exactly on your prototype A. So what you can do, you can, in that case, you can go to the tools, 3D body placement, and then orient and position the 3D body. In this case, what basically this function does is that it orient itself and position the 3D body into your PCB template, in case if it's available, or your previous PCB. So choose orient and position 3D body, and as soon as you select that option here, you can see that pick the step model to place. So for that, what you have to do, you have to first pick up the step model. So here I clicked, I wanted to pick up this step model. So now it's asking pick a point to be used as the main anchor. So now you have to select the 3 point, and you should remember the sequence in which you are selecting those 3 points. So let me start from here. So this is my first point. Then this is my second point. And this is my third point. And so here, once you are finished with 3 points, then it's asking you pick the main anchor destination. In the same sequence, you should also select the same position on your template PCB, or the PCB where you have to put this 3D step data. So this was one of the position, and in this position you can see that as soon as you select the center, then its color changes. So this is first. You have to find out that this is second, and the third one is here. So as soon as I have given these 3 positions on my PCB, you have seen that it's automatically oriented itself to these positions. And we can go to the 2D mode, and here you can see that, yeah, looks good. Just to be to make sure, you can go to the keep out and you can check the border whether it's the same or not. Yeah, looks good. So that's how you can use that function. Then let me again shift this body from here to the right side to show you how you can use the another function. So you can again go to the tools, 3D body placement, and then position 3D body. So this function you can also use. So choose this, position 3D body. So Here you can see that it's asking you pick the step model to place. So this is the step model which we have to place on the our template PCB. So I have chosen, and then it's asking for pick a point to be used at the anchor. So one point you have to choose. So let me choose this point and then pick the anchor point destination. So for example, in case when if you don't want to take three positions or four positions on your step model and just only one, and you are sure that there is no problem with the placement, or it will fit your 3D step model fit correctly on your destination PCB, then you can just use this option. And here, let me find out that center. Yeah. So you can see that option you can also use. As soon as you have chosen this, the PCB is automatically, it has taken that position. So those are the method which you can use to put the 3D step model on your destination PCB. That's how you can place 3D model in Altium Designer 24.10. If this video is useful for you, then please subscribe to my channel and like the video. Thank you very much.